Hi, I'm Dr. Donovan, and in this video, we're going to explore vitamin D deficiency, including what it is, why it matters, how to spot it, and how it can be treated and prevented. As always, this is an educational video only. If you've got any concerns about your health, please speak to your own healthcare provider. So firstly, what is vitamin D deficiency? Well, we're going to start with the very basics. Vitamin D deficiency means that your body doesn't have enough vitamin D, a nutrient that is crucial for healthy bones, muscles, and overall well-being. Now, vitamin D helps your body to absorb calcium and phosphorus, two minerals essential for bone health. It also supports your immune system and plays a role in muscle function and even mood regulation. Now, you get vitamin D in three main ways: from sunlight exposure on your skin, from certain foods, and from supplements. But when your intake or production is too low, it can lead to deficiency. So why is vitamin D important? Well, in children, vitamin D deficiency can cause rickets, a condition that weakens bones and can cause deformities like bowed legs. In adults, low vitamin D increases the risk of osteoporosis or thinning of the bones, which raises the chance of fractures. But that's not all. Vitamin D is also thought to help maintain muscle strength, support immune function, and reduce the risk of falls in older adults, and possibly protect against certain cancers and even mood disorders like depression. So it is a really, really important vitamin. So how much vitamin D do you need? Well, in the UK, it's recommended that most people over the age of one take a supplement of 10 micrograms or 400 international units per day from October to March, when sunlight isn't strong enough to make vitamin D naturally. But some people are also advised to take it all year round, including those who are pregnant or breastfeeding, are over 65, spend most of their time indoors, cover their skin for cultural reasons, or have darker skin tones such as African, African Caribbean, or South Asian backgrounds. Now, babies under 1 year should also receive vitamin D drops unless they're formula fed, in which case they'll usually be getting enough from the milk. Now let's move on and talk about some symptoms of vitamin D deficiency. Well, vitamin D deficiency can be tricky to spot because it often causes very vague or subtle signs at first. Now, in adults, common symptoms can include fatigue, a general sense of not feeling well, muscle weakness, especially difficulty climbing stairs or standing from a seated position, bone or joint pain, especially in the lower back, the hips, or the legs. Now, in more severe cases, people may walk with a waddling gait due to weakened muscles. In children, deficiency can be more serious, and it might cause bone deformities like bowed legs or a soft skull, delayed walking or teething, bone pain or poor growth, irritability and a tendency to pick up infections more easily, and in babies, severe deficiency might cause muscle cramps or spasms, seizures, or even breathing difficulties. Now, these symptoms are often linked to low calcium levels that result from the lack of vitamin D. So now let's move on and discuss what causes vitamin D deficiency, because this is really important to know. Now, there are a few possibilities. You might not be getting enough sunlight, especially in winter or if you're housebound. You might, for example, cover your skin or wear sunscreen all of the time. You also might have darker skin, which reduces the skin's ability to make vitamin D from sunlight. Also, if you're elderly, as older skin doesn't produce vitamin D as well, or if you've got medical conditions like Crohn's, celiac disease, or liver or kidney problems. Other people might be taking medications that interfere with vitamin D metabolism, like some anti-epileptic or HIV medications, or if you follow a vegan or vegetarian diet with few vitamin D-rich foods. And of course, some people may just need more vitamin D, such as growing children, pregnant women, or those who are breastfeeding. So let's move on and discuss how common is vitamin D deficiency. Well, it's actually very common. In the UK, about 1 in 5 adults and 1 in 5 children are thought to have low vitamin D levels. It's more common in winter and spring when sunlight is weaker, especially in these Northern Hemisphere countries. So how is it diagnosed? Well, if you or your doctor suspects a deficiency, the diagnosis is confirmed with a blood test to check your vitamin D level. Blood calcium, phosphate, and liver function tests might also be done. In children, a wrist X-ray might be used to assess how the bones are developing if rickets is suspected. So let's now just discuss how it's treated. Well, treatment depends on how low your levels are. For most people, vitamin D supplements are the main treatment. You might be given a high dose course daily, weekly, or monthly to boost levels quickly, or a maintenance dose, often 10 micrograms a day, to keep your levels stable. In rare cases, an injection may be offered, but this is used less often nowadays. Once your levels are back to normal, your doctor will usually recommend continuing with the lower dose to prevent further deficiency. Now, there are also important ways to get vitamin D naturally. Firstly, there is sunlight. For fair-skinned people, 20 to 30 minutes of sun exposure on the face and forearms a few days a week during summer is usually enough. But remember, this only works if the sun is strong enough and your skin is uncovered. On the other hand, you need to be conscious to make sure that you're taking adequate sun protection, because staying in the sun for too long can obviously cause serious skin damage and even skin cancer. Now, for people with darker skin, making enough vitamin D from sunlight alone might be more difficult, and in this case, a supplement might be recommended all year round. Vitamin D can also be found in foods like oily fish, so salmon, mackerel, and sardines, egg yolks and liver, as well as fortified foods, so things like cereals, spreads, and baby formula. So people often ask the question, are there any risks with supplements? Well, generally vitamin D is safe, but high doses can cause problems in certain situations. It may interact with medications like digoxin or diuretics, and also people with kidney disease or a history of kidney stones should use supplements with caution. Multivitamins usually contain too much vitamin A to be safe for long-term high-dose vitamin D treatment, so it's typically better to get a separate vitamin D supplement. Let's just now briefly discuss some of the complications of vitamin D deficiency. So untreated vitamin D deficiency can lead to serious complications. Like I mentioned, in children it can cause rickets, and in adults it can lead to osteomalacia, which is a softening of the bones. It may also increase your risk of falls, bone fractures, and other bone problems. There's also emerging evidence linking vitamin D deficiency to diseases like diabetes, heart disease, some cancers, and even Alzheimer's, though much more research is needed on this. The good news is that the outlook is excellent with treatment. Vitamin D levels usually recover well with supplements, and symptoms like fatigue and bone pain often improve within a few weeks or months of taking enough vitamin D. However, bones may take longer to heal in severe cases. So in summary, vitamin D deficiency is common, often subtle, but very easy to treat. Getting enough vitamin D can help protect your bones, your muscles, as well as your overall well-being. If you think you might be deficient or fall into the high-risk group that we discussed, please speak with your healthcare provider about testing or starting supplements. Thanks for watching, and if you found the video helpful, please like, share, or subscribe for more easy-to-understand health content, which I produce every week. And please also check out the description box of this video for more useful resources on this topic. Take care, and see you next time.